Two Sonics as if it's one player. That's so stupid.
No, it's not.
I think
you'll see. You'll see what's up with it.
Yeah, still.
Yes, this is Bacon Man, starting a Let's Play of Sonic Generations with my guest star, Ted. Well, do you have a YouTube username?
Yeah, Dark Assault 42.
So, anyways, Ted and I are going to be mashing out some Sonic Generations. He's playing it blind. I've already whipped almost 90% of the game, 95% of the game, without buying any of the upgrades or skills. I think, no wait, I bought the Sega Genesis with my skill points so I could play Sonic 1, and I whipped that too. No, you hit the home button, get out of that.
I forgot to
sign in. Oh, okay. Sign in on yours then. Yeah, otherwise it'll load my save game.
That's a great way to start a video.
It happens. That's like one of the merits about Xbox over that. I mean, you can sign in different profiles at the same time. For PS3, you kind of have to duck out and then sign in with your other profiles.
That was actually,
which is kind of lame.
Call of Duty games on PS3, because they wouldn't let you load more than one profile, even if you're playing multiplayer.
So if you want to play multiplayer at a friend's house, you can't.
Yeah, if you want to play split screen, you can load your own profile.
Yeah.
That's why 360 is one of the better consoles, because they allow you to do that.
Yeah, but you're also paying per month for your internet things, too. And those damn controllers. Ugh. I mean, don't get me wrong, most of the controller is sound, but have you ever tried playing a fighting game on the D-pad for the 360? The D-pad just has...
You gotta get used to the
controls,
horrible. Though. You're
it's
used
horrible.
To PS3.
Yeah, I'm used to Super Nintendo, which is why I like PS3. And stuff beyond PS1, actually.
Yeah.
That was the only thing that kept me from getting into Sega systems, too. Except, like I said in a previous video, the Dreamcast.
Speaking of Sega, we're playing
Sonic. You see how that works. Now, the thing is, you can get 360-style controllers for the PS3 anywhere. But I have never seen anywhere where I can get a 360 controller that's a PS3-style controller that works for the 360.
See,
I mean, what's the deal with that?
I don't know. I like the big blue Sonic better than the little one.
Do you even understand the difference between them yet?
Dude, I haven't played Sonic in years.
Time to get back in the game. I gotta say, this is probably the best Sonic game I've ever played.
I'm guessing it's from two different worlds.
Really? What would make you think that?
The fact that we know a lot about...
You might want to turn the brightness setting all the way up for both the video and the fact that my TV is at a funky angle.
What the hell?
Now... Do you want Oma Chow appearing going, Mega Man, Mega Man, you need to press the jump button here to keep from falling in the pit. I would turn that off. It's just annoying. Controller hints, you can turn that on. It's basically when you get to a certain point, it'll tell you what button to press. Don't even mess with Oma Chow. You can always turn him back on if you get stuck, but really, I don't think you're going to get stuck in these levels. This is like... the greatest level design going on out in Sonic games. Probably second only to Demons and Dark Souls right now, in my opinion.
There's a classic thing.
That's right, you run back and forth and jump. And you can spin dash with square or by holding down and hitting jump. And those are bad guys. Clearly you don't want them pegging you. Those boxes give you 10 rings. Come on, it's...
I told you I haven't played in years. Whoa, what the hell?
That kind of shows... Who can forget that moment, huh? An old school Sonic 1?
Right.
The game manages to catch all the little set pieces like that that make you remember it, and it branches it with new content. Fresh new content.
Yeah.
which is really great. And this also teaches you, you don't win the game by holding right as fast as you can. You actually have to take some time and precision. Honestly, that's the thing with Sonic games and old school Sonic games that some gamer snobs don't really get. It's only 10% speed and 90% precision and knowing where you're going. So where you use the spin dash.
Go, Sonic.
Whoa. Way to go. But no, honestly, I would take both systems over neither any day. But,
I do not like you.
But also, I've heard that 360s have a lot more hardware issues than PS3s ever did, besides maybe the first gen.
Maybe.
And that's a lesson. And that's a lesson the PS2 taught me to value.
I don't know as many problems as everybody else
does. Well, everybody else also plays their games like tries to play through an entire RPG in a single sitting. It's like, I know jobs are bad, but there's still more to life than that. Sadly.
I can pretty much see the little circles coming before I even see them.
Yeah. Although technically that's an Emerald Hill moment, but it's still a moment and it still matters. It's there.
Oh, so close. Oh, I got an A.
Yep. Not bad for your first time. And that's how Shorty Sonic works.
Now on to the next Sonic. Yeah, this is why I hate when my voice does this.
Honestly, thank goodness there aren't too many cutscenes in the game. There's a couple, but once you do them once, you don't even have to repeat the cutscenes ever again. You can just jump straight through the levels.
Freaking, I hate getting sick.
Yeah,
I'm over
so
being
do I.
sick, but it's winter, and my throat is retarded right now.
How are your knees?
Fuck you. Oh my god, it's the awesome looking Tails. Hey guys. Not the retarded one from Sonic Riders.
From Sonic Riders, yeah.
Long skinny neck.
With the neck that's longer than his tails.
Yeah.
See, and all the buddies do appear. But you don't have to, like, play the levels as them.
Rouge is sexy, to say the least. You totally got me
this time. You're such a furry.
Happy birthday, Sonic. Hope you like this.
Fucking chili dogs, yeah.
Yeah, it's the first time they actually put chili dogs in a Sonic game.
I know, his favorite food.
And it's been in the cartoons all these years. I mean, how many cartoons are there now? 4 or 5?
I guess. Oh man, not the chili dog.
Sonic, what's that?
And that's all he cares
about. That's all
about.
He cares about, yeah. That's one of the key differences between old and new Sonic. New Sonic's like, oh man, where's my chili dog?
So I'm guessing I'm gonna find out what that bad guy is.
No, not today.
How long
do I just... don't think you're that good at the game.
Thank you. How long should this game take?
It took me 3 sittings. But then you see me, I play a game like 1 or 2 hours.
Yeah.
So probably like 6 to 8 hours. But no, you're not going to get bored of this because it's so much fun. Even though collecting the red rings is kind of frustrating.
Red rings.
We'll get more into that once you beat Green Hill Zone.
Oh, joy.
And now, modern day Sonic gets to go through Green Hill Zone his own way. Which might be a little more in tune with how you're used to playing.
I never understood the belt buckles on his shoe.
They never used to have it until they got into Adventure. Maybe it's because he doesn't know how to tie laces.
Old fashioned shoes.
Super Velcro. And now here's your level head.
Oh, I like that.
Yeah, you press square to boost. You press jump to twice to homing attack. I forget what circle does. I know circle in the air does like a stomp, but you're not even going to use that for a good number of levels. And then you can also use the L and R buttons to grind while you're turning.
Nice.
That'll really come into play when you hit the adventure part of the game.
You really didn't start grinding until the newer generation of Sonic,
huh? Kinda, yeah. But then you could also grind rails, and it's not like in Riders, like, you will auto freaking... They set up the grinding really good. I'll just leave it at that. See when there's the target? You jump through those rings and they'll launch you forward. You can also boost in the air.
Ooh.
And you can boost through groups of enemies.
I'm enjoying this.
And this plays like 2D segments with your 3D powers. I told you you'd probably like this part better. Jump. And then finally come to the third type of thing. A part where you fall down a little ways. No, this is chutes. Remember Sonic 2 special stages?
No.
Well, that, you're basically just doing that in the middle of the level. You can boost while you're grinding too.
I want to take this by the way. Holy shit.
Those just build your boost gauge up. You can also hit the L1 and R1 buttons together during that. Oh.
Yeah, I screwed that one up.
Yeah, you did. If you can find a way to take a hit in Green Hill Zone, you know you suck. I bet you'll never guess what happens next.
I don't know, but this is quite fun.
You can also use the L1 and R1 buttons while you're running forward like that, and it'll shift between, like, different lanes.
I fell.
Died.
You're right, it's not about speeding through it, though.
Yeah. It's all about accuracy.
Super Sonic isn't in this. Right?
Depends. See how the L1, R1 quick navigate works?
Yeah.
It's such an awesome addition to the game.
Oh, so close.
Still, not bad for your first time playing a Sonic game since, what?
Since I was probably like 10.
Yeah, 98.
Something like that.
Since you were 10, so what, 3 years ago?
Screw you two. At least I'm not a 30-year-old pedal bear.
I know. I give it another 3 years. You'll get there.
Thanks, Sonic. I thought I was dead, floating without a body in a black limbo.
Freaking tail is always so smart.
But unfortunately, being smart doesn't make you fast.
No. But it does make you fly.
Or is that place we were just in awfully familiar?
Not to me. This place looks like something sucked out of
How was he there?
Totally strange.
And what game does that remind you of?
No stranger than rescuing genies.
Suck the life and color out of the world.
In an interstellar amusement park. I'm more concerned about finding our friends.
That reminds me of a few games, actually.
Hey, yeah. Sonic, I saw something over there in the distance. Like buildings, but they look weird.
Eggman's factory.
Really? This early? Huh? You never know.
That's a possibility.
Boy, I can tell you haven't played Sonic in 20 years.
You weren't kidding when you said soon. I thought you already left.
Huh. He doesn't realize it's the other Sonic.
No, nobody realizes it.
They should notice that he's shorter and lighter and his hair isn't as long.
I'm sure you couldn't tell the difference to begin with either.
Yes, I could.
No, when you get to the first boss, it'll show you another fundamental difference between modern and classic Sonic.
Yeah.
You have to complete each zone with each Sonic. One's Act 1 and one's Act 2.
Okay, why won't I do anything?
Because it's saving your progress.
What's with the stars?
Okay, there's 5 red rings in every level. They don't appear during the intro to the game, but going back through the level again, they'll generally pop up in the areas that you're supposed to go to zip through the level quicker.
Now, if I go and do all the levels instead of going after the red rings, can I go back after I finish it?
Yeah, okay. Absolutely. You can repeat levels as many times as you want, go for high scores, go for quick times.
You guys can't see it, but I'm dancing to the music.
How do you not love that? How do you not love the Chemical Plant thing? It's like the only good thing to come out of the 90s. Besides Xena Warrior Princess. And the American Pie movies.
Freaking Xena and American Pie. I recognize that little bugger.
So, how well do you think your girl would do with this game? I'm pretty sure mine would tear the crap out of it.
I think she'd do well enough for her age. Because she does love soft games.
Yeah, and you see how she does in Riders and how hard that was to learn?
Yeah.
Now consider how easy this game is to learn. And the fact that it's a Sonic game that makes sense.
I don't get why I'm able to go backwards here, okay?
It's so you can eat up extra timer.
I'm collecting rings just because I want to. Or not. Ooh.
See, and here's where I would take a different route. Just because I would have made that jump. There's one red ring. Well.
I don't even know where the hell I'm going. I kind of failed that one.
No, you can't fail that one.
Oh, okay, I see. It's just a little bit difficult to keep them on the platform because they move so well. What's that?
What's what?
That's
a midpoint marker, and if you're below 5 rings, you'll have 5 rings when you pass through it. This is probably like my favorite music of the whole game. Of the whole series. And how do you not love it? How can anyone not love it?
Okay, that's a
Wow, you really haven't played this game in forever.
No. Oh, crap.
Don't worry, the goo is not instant death.
Yeah, but it's still quite annoying.
You're doing splendid.
No, I'm not. I'm almost dead.
No, you're not.
I don't really want to lose.
Sure you do.
Crap, no.
No turning around now.
What the hell?
Go, 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 go. Spin too long in the water, you drown. You remember why everyone loves
right
the timer. Yep. That's very well played.
I could
tell. I think you were trying to dodge it and you failed to.
Yeah, finish the level.
Yeah.
I do love this game.
It only took you three.
They keep the classic and they keep them out of it.
Yeah.
And somehow I still end up with an A.
What it does, if you get through a whole level without dying once, it boosts you up a rank. And that's how you get the S ranks on everything. You have to get an A class time without dying.
So,
which is kind of a pain in the butt when you're trying to get the red ring.
And I've got 2 out of 3 for this one.
2 out of 5.
Five.
That's not
sorry.
Bad. For your first run, that explains what they do. They build up collection rooms, usually artwork and extra background musics. And when you get extra background musics, then you can change it so a level plays one of the custom background musics.
Nice.
But some of them are really kicking.
Now let's try
It makes me wish they had a Hydrosity Zone in the game.
Now let's try New Age Zone again on that same level.
Haha.
I think I'll do Classic Sonic first with each mission.
That's generally the way it's made to go.
And then I'll do New Sonic. Ooh, I like that.
There's only one place where Classic Sonic is a breeze and Classic Sonic is the freaking hardest crap ever and Modern Sonic is a breeze. And I'm not going to tell you what it is. Also, see that yellow thing on the side? That's a rail you can grind. To the left.
Okay, I see. Whoa!
Hello. All
right.
Oh. And yeah, boost running lets you climb on top of the water. So even though you can't fly in this game, you actually can semi-swim, I guess. It's just so masterful. Like I said, it's the best Sonic game ever.
Red ring.
Yeah.
I got it, but I got the way in.
Sometimes it's worth taking a hit or two. It's just a clumsy place to do that.
Ooh, I like this part.
Yeah, it's like a little part of Sonic 2 Special Stage. And now, like Sonic Advance Special Stage.
Oh, alright, see, that was a little harder to control.
Yeah, because there's momentum involved.
He's going to move this way slow and then fast.
Or we should start right back there again. This level, like, is pure genius.
Oh, I missed the red ring.
Yeah, but that's how you learn where they're at. Oh, that's how you do that.
What?
Well played.
What?
I didn't even think about using the circle to freaking slow you down.
I didn't know I did slow you down. Okay, that was kind of stupid.
Nice try. I can tell you're concentrating a lot. I'm not talking too much. I really do hope they come out with more downloadable levels for this, though.
That would be awesome.
I know. Everyone's hoping that. Everyone everywhere would just love more levels for this.
Whoa. Oh, I missed that.
Huh. That's okay. It took you to the same place you would have gone anyway. It just would have been a lot quicker. Saved you some time.
I really saw it.
How do you not?
What about the...
So, best Sonic game ever?
By far.
You're not even up to the funny parts.
Oh, dude.
What? You did a backflip?
What? I made it all the way to full pay.
Yeah.
If I made it just a little bit further, I would have got rank S.
Sonic!
No. You would have got a rank S if you didn't die in that tunnel.
This chemical plant feels familiar.
That's true. So I could have had a rank S like just now. If I hadn't died.
Water makes me really nervous for some reason.
You're right, Tails. This place has given me deja vu all over again.
Why would it give Tails a creepy feeling? He could die as many times as he wants.
That is not.
Have you never played Sonic 2 or 3?
Dude, remember Tails, how many times can, are we going
to say this? Dying? Oh, yeah. Remember, Tails can keep dying as long as Sonic stays alive.
Oh, nice.
So if you want to be really cheap, you can just pick up the Player 2 controller and take on the bosses with Tails and just park Sonic somewhere kind of safe.
I got one red ring that time.
Yep.
This game shouldn't take too long to finish.
Yeah, not a whole heck of a long time.
You saved me, Sonic. I'm
afraid
I'm
Amy, dude, she's such
again.
A stalker.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's also why girls always carry hammers in their purses.
Right.
Because, unfortunately, there's so many guys like her out there. Yeah. Effing chicks, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you can get extra skills in the skill shop, but that's just a big old waste of honky to me.
Yeah.
But it might help you if you get stuck. So if you get stuck somewhere, you might visit the skill shop. Yeah, there's a big ol' overworld here you can check out. It's not very useful right now, though.
Not until I finish it, huh?
Well, what makes you think that?
Shut up.
Okay, time to get your pants on. Crap just got real.
What stage is this?
That's what you learn when you get through it. See those little signs right there?
Yeah.
It's like a warning that there's a cheap kill if you drop down around this.
Okay, that was kind of lame.
Yeah, I'd agree there. The freaking death egg is taking off. It's the game's rough equal of it. It's called Sky Sanctuary Zone. Basically, it's the capital of Knuckles Kingdom, or whatever his land is, where he protects the Master Emeralds. It's probably the second or third to last level in Sonic and Knuckles, I think. We went from here to the Death Egg, and then that was the final encounter.
Okay, that was cool.
Yeah, you can't go back down there. And then you poofed the jump.
Oh, whoa. Okay,
and that's
I didn't
what those
see that
do.
Coming.
Then you live and learn.
Okay, what the hell was that about?
You had
though?
To jump.
I did.
Apparently not soon enough. The clouds will do that.
He doesn't even jump that high.
Well, don't try to spin dash through it. Just run and jump when you get close to the end. So. Remember, 90% accuracy. Yeah, this is where the game gets real.
No, wrong way.
Fortunately, the level's built to catch you if you do it that way. Now, that's a little disorienting, but it's doable. It's not hard. We've been chilling out here a few days now. They kind of got me a little into Fable 3 and Skyrim. I can see why Fable 3 is a 10-star game now. That's what I was getting at a little bit ago with the whole, color fading from the world thing.
With the darkness.
And I'm still not super impressed with Skyrim, but I can see why people like it now. It's like a big old Deus Ex. That one of us is playing like an adventure game, another is playing like a Metal Gear game, and it's a lot more character and dialogue oriented. Kind of like how Zelda Oracle of Seasons is more action oriented and Ages is more character oriented. Skyrim's like the alternative Dark Souls for that, so it seems. Being able to reconfigure the control scheme helped me there a lot, too. Because my Dark Souls instincts was getting me into a lot of trouble there.
Yeah, I really was getting into trouble.
Yes.
Oh, so many. And Mr. Red Ring.
Yep. That's what you can come back for later. That's what you do. You play it once, you live and learn. The game really captures.
Or
captured.
I could just do this.
Yeah, that worked out really good.
Chill out.
No, I know what you're getting at. That's what.
Okay. Even though you're only supposed
exactly.
to do it one way, you can do it too.
Yeah. Believe it or not, Sonic's abilities actually extend beyond how some of the levels are designed. You can pull off some crazy stuff. Yeah, just keep running.
That was kind of hard to
what
do.
What the hell? No, you can keep running. You don't have to spin dash that. As you run, it goes up. You build up speed and it'll go up. But you've only got so long.
Yeah, it really doesn't work. And now it's just stuck. That's a lame glitch.
Not a glitch, really, but...
Okay, that wasn't cool.
Well, you're down there now. Time to make the most of it. Yeah, sometimes the game isn't merciful enough to kill you. Sometimes it makes you live with the consequences of missing a jump. Which I think is a far better thing.
Yeah.
That's the kind I was thinking about when it comes to the game dev stuff and the dungeon layouts. That's what I was thinking of. Like, maybe failing to do something will just force you to take another track. Maybe a more challenging or less rewarding one. Maybe a less challenging one. But it's that kind of non-linear level design that made the classic Sonic games so good. And that's what a lot of the modern Sonic games forgot. It just pretty much... Yeah. Yeah, you're starting to get it.
Oh, lame. So lame.
You got spiked. That's why I had you turn the visibility up. You can keep running against the wall and it'll still go up.
This level is quite annoying, though. Yes, I'm not really good at the Sonic, at the classic Sonic, as I am at the other one.
That's okay, you've only got a little more of this classic one to go, and then you go to Modern Sky Sanctuary. I'm really good at the classics, but Modern Sky Sanctuary was my first tripping point. It probably took me like 3 playthroughs to get all the way through.
Okay, I got this one. No, I don't.
Not that way, you don't. I would have laughed if that laser found a way to magically hit you.
I know, right? There we go. This should be fun.
Run, 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 run!
Oh, believe me, I'm running.
Nope. Run, run, run.
Hey, all three of us had a red ring.
Yeah.
Nice.
That was the other thing about this. You had to find 3 ways through the level to get the red ring. It was kind of annoying.
But it was
kind of cool once you got there. Because it basically shows you all these levels have more than one way through them. Which is what makes them so effing good.
And that's what made Sonic good in the first place.
Exactly. And when the Adventures and Heroes came out, they totally threw that in the can. And that's kind of why they suck.
Well, they also threw it in the can when they made Shadow the Hedgehog.
But at least there they were being straightforward enough to say, yeah, we're making a different type of game here. We're not going to call it a Sonic game.
That's true.
Everything else that they've called a Sonic game... They've made really, really linear, and sometimes with jumps that you could make, and then like you'd hit an invisible wall because that's where the end of the level was, at the edge of the level, and you'd fall down. I was like, "What the heck happened?" Uh-huh. Alrighty, people, here's where it gets real.
Well, screw you. I'm on the Sonic I like.
That's true. You might surprise me, because again, I was more accustomed to the 2D, which is why this one just screwed me up.
Yeah.
Although I will admit, I like the remake of the music on this one better.
I didn't know what that was about, but okay.
That's the stunt thing you did before. Remember where you did the stunts in the air and it powered up your boost meter?
Yes.
That's what that was.
Oh, so lame.
Look at the whole... Oh.
What is that?
Someone up. Old and new Zelda game. It's like two totally different things. Although I hear Retro Studios is working on the new Legend of Zelda, so it might actually go back to its roots. Who knows? Yeah, the accidental jump button thing, it killed me. Like, I'd go for a jump or whatever, and I'd end up accidentally getting the homing attack when I wasn't high enough in my jump, and then whoosh! Yeah, if there's a rail you can ride on, you can homing attack into the rail. I think you can do tricks off of anything rainbowy like that.
How do you do the trick though? It doesn't really show you.
You just hit the directional buttons different ways, and I think there's a finisher if you push L1 and R1 together.
That's right, you have to hit directional buttons.
Yeah. You can homing attack that too. That was another nifty touch I noticed. Like, as long as you were boosting, it added an extra drum beat. Like, I wonder what the soundtrack would sound like with the boost drum beat turned on the whole time.
I do like the teleporter.
Hmm?
I do like the teleporter. Oh, hell.
How'd you do that?
I slightly moved the analog the other way.
See, yeah, that's the thing with stuff, like with analog stick systems, they do annoying crap like that. And then here's the thing, like, with the PS3, you have the D-pad that gives you a workaround from that. The reason the 360 D-pad really sucks to me is because the D-pad on that doesn't. It looks just like another analog stick.
Okay.
That egg robot was just a big old coward, huh?
What?
That egg robot was just a big old coward, huh? Hey, I'm just gonna go over here and hit the switch so you can't go here.
Even though it allowed me to go there. Holy fuck. Oh, you bastard. See if I can do it again. Nope. Oh, okay. That one's kind of lame.
No, that's just a trick jump to go around. something you can't speed through. It tries to speed you through it, but you can't just speed through it, finally.
I finished it one death.
Yep. And in about 5.5 minutes. Not bad for your first playthrough. You did better on that one than I thought you would.
And it only gets harder from there.
Does it?
Probably.
Nah, why would a game do something like that?
Because video games always do that. But it's good, because you learn. It doesn't make it a pussy game for you.
I like one that explains to you every 5 seconds what to do.
Yeah. Even he doesn't have shoestrings, he has metal bars on his shoes.
Thanks for the help, not that I needed it. Good to have my sanctuary back.
Bolt them shut.
I mean, seriously, where do they get those shoes?
I don't know.
It's so white and creepy.
I thought like you said creamy.
Like my last ex-girlfriend. And then, yeah, you get extra challenge mode.
I think I'm just going to continue with this story.
That'd be nice, huh? You have to do at least one per region to get the boss keys. You gotta get 3 boss keys in order to get to the boss. And we'll take care of that and be back later. Rock on.